I'm looking at Matthew 5:13, and Jesus has something to say about you there. He says, you are the salt of the earth. Very strong statement. Now, there's more to that verse, and if you're like me, you might think the rest of that verse is saying, after you are the salt of the earth, don't mess this up. That's kind of what it feels like, but I don't think that's what's happening. It says, you are the salt of the earth, but if the salt have lost its savor, with what shall it be salted? So I think what's happening here is Jesus is making a point of logic in the same way that he makes a point of logic in you are the light of the world. So in you are the light of the world, which is in 14, it says, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither does a man light a lamp to put it under a bushel, but he puts it on a lampstand. So I think the point of logic is light does what light does. And I think it's the same for this verse 13. You are the salt of the earth. And if salt isn't salty anymore, what do you salt salt with? It's like, what, salt? No, if it's not salty, it's not even salt anymore. You throw it out. So I think his point of logic is light does what light does, salt does what salt does. And you are the salt of the earth. And so what does salt do? I've written some things on this page about salt. Salt purifies. It cleanses. It prevents the spreading of infection or corruption. Salt heals. You are a healing influence. Salt preserves. It preserves from decay, from rotting, from spoiling. It preserves good and promotes life. And of course, salt adds flavor, a zest to life. And salt creates thirst. It stirs a deep craving. So these are the things that you do. There's healing in who you are. You bring healing. Healing is in you to take to us. Now, I have this salt cellar at home, salt shaker. You know, here's the thing about salt shakers. I'm used to the type of salt shaker. You pick it up like this. You bring it to your food. You tip it and shake it a little bit. And there's holes in the top and the salt comes out. I have this salt device at home where there are no holes in the top. The holes are in the bottom. So every place you set the salt device, there's salt. It's everywhere. I tried to contain it by getting a plate, putting it on the plate. The plate fills up with salt. And it's all around. You're saying, what kind of, I don't know, it's a grinder. You put big pieces of salt in it and grind it and they come, but it gets everywhere. I take the salt to put on my eggs. And as I'm bringing it over, there's a trail of salt coming over. I get some on my eggs. It's great, but there's salt everywhere. And so I was thinking about how do we move ourselves to a position. This salt shaker irritates me, but that's not the point. The point is we move into places where that become salted because we're there. So I wanted to look at a couple of ways that Jesus moved into places and brought these things that salt brings. So in Matthew 9:36, it says this, but when Jesus saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion. Moved with compassion on them because they were faint and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. So he was being like a shepherd. He was seeing something that wasn't being preserved. Salt preserves. And he was moved with compassion on this situation. Matthew 14:14 says, "And Jesus went forth and saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion toward them and healed their sick." And then in Mark 1:41, this is where a leper comes to Jesus and says, what does he say? He says, if you will, you can make me clean. And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him and said unto him, "I will be clean." So I just see you are the salt of the earth. And wherever you are, it's going to be salty. It really can't be contained, and you can't mess it up because you are salt. But one thing that we can do is we can move into places. And what moves us? Compassion moves us. Not anything else. Like Jesus, we need to let compassion move us into the space where we can be salt, salt of the earth.